I just want to say that I've been called on the phone Suresh a lot, in the sense that people, because Cyrus being a Parsi name, not everybody picks it up and all. So over the years, it's one of my go-to names, by the way. It doesn't happen reverse because Suresh is an easy name. But it happens to me all my life. I've been like, kaun hai? Cyrus. Suresh.
You're now looking like Tanmay Bhatiyar.
Oh, I better change then.
How mean. He's quite, he's a potty guy. But
sweet, yeah.
He's very cute. His, I know lots of girls who find him very attractive.
I think this is more appropriate for my age also.
this is captivating. I myself am feeling a pull towards you.
Yeah. That's scary.
Oh my God.
For all film-related interviews, reviews, and content, please like and subscribe to Pooja Talwar. You can also follow me on Twitter and on Instagram.
They say it's always a good time when you have Cyrus and Suresh. I was mixing up your names together in the house. Now, Suresh, why are you looking different? Yeah? Every time I see you, you have a different hairdo.
It's a genetic thing. Every decade, he does change. Pooja, I just want to say that I've been called on the phone Suresh a lot, in the sense that people, because Cyrus being a Parsi name, not everybody picks it up and all. So over the years, it's one of my go-to names, by the way. It doesn't happen reverse because Suresh is an easy name, but it happens to me all my life. I've been like, kaun hai? Cyrus. Suresh. Cyrus. Suresh. So after some time, you know, it's I don't want to use the molesting metaphor, but you just grin and bear it. It's because there's no point arguing with people and explaining to them ki boss, ye Parsi naam hai, idhar se aa gaya, iska pronunciation aisa hai. So between Cybal in Bengal and Suresh in the rest of India, I'm more than happy.
So see, now you can understand why I have to wear wigs to catch attention, because if Brocha talks, nobody can get any attention. So then I wear wigs, I keep on turning them like this at times.
Suresh, my darling, what Pooja say is not about the wig. It is about the quality of the wig. Please understand what she's trying to say.
I'm trying to wear this and walk outside colleges and see if I can, you know.
You're now looking like Tanmay Bhatiyar.
Oh, ooh. I better change then.
How mean. He's quite, he's a potty guy, but
sweet,
he's very cute. In his, I know lots of girls who find him very attractive.
I think this is more appropriate for my age.
this is captivating. I myself am feeling a pull towards you. Yeah.
That's scary.
Oh my God. You know, I usually get nervous when I'm around guys like you, because, you know, you are so witty and I never have a repartee so well. And your hosts, Baman and Arshad, both told me, now Suresh, this is not aimed at you, for Cyrus. They said we thought he would be the first one to be eliminated because he's got a smiley face.
They can't tell you who came where. They gave us a lecture. Suresh, you were warned 20 times not to mention who came where and placements. What is wrong with the anchors? Suspending them.
Yeah, yeah.
But this is what they had to say about you. He keeps smiling. We thought he'd be the first one. He and Sunil Grover would be the first one to be eliminated.
Yeah,
true.
Yeah, but Cyrus has got a very smiling face, and he, you know, but you know, he managed to control his smile.
Suresh, when people see you, what do you think? They do cry?
No, they actually.
Is it my fault? A man in his 50s who wears a wig like a YMCA character from that group, that village people.
YMCA.
Yeah, yeah, that village people, they all have these strange headgears and all. See, but it's a gay anthem. Nothing wrong with that.
Brocha, when people look at me, they admire beauty. And when they look at you, they laugh or they smile. That's fair enough.
Lack of beauty. Both ways we work. That's what you're saying. I get it. Fair enough. Yeah. Now, you see, Pooja's being very nice to us. We go back a long way, so hopefully she won't be rude and mean. But,
of course, never.
But you could screw it up.
I had some very fun moments with Cyrus when we went to universities and corrupted an entire generation in the 90s.
With no budgets, Pooja Talwar, with no money, no lunch break. Those are really hard days. One day you should write about that. Sorry.
These days grumble about working overtime if they only knew what we had been through.
Oh, really? Yeah.
So it's 5 lunch break. But I took a 6 o'clock morning flight to go to Delhi and shoot immediately. And no food till 5. But I didn't say anything. I thought it was fun.
Same here.
But guys, honestly, tell me, what was it like in the LOL studios? What was it like when you looked at each other's face? How was it, tough to control? And you know, or did you know which is the weak point, and how does one go about it?
So Brocha and me avoided each other, actually, because
we really did.
It's going to be a problem. So, instinctively, we just avoided each other. First
there's so much classical conditioning between, say, two of us and a few others who had some past history or chemistry rather. So I didn't, like, how we were laughing and giggling. We giggle, we're like schoolgirls, me and Suresh. So, you know, honestly, you leave us alone. We just talk rubbish or whatever, yeah, and we just pass the time. He's a great guy to hang out with. We spend a lot of time with him, and, you know, it's always fun and infectious. So wanted to avoid that, because you get into the spirit of the sport, so to speak, where it's at the end of the day, you know, all competitive people with you. All very nice off the camera or offline, if you want to use it that way. But once the game started, believe me, they were all predators. So I wanted to avoid, I thought he'd be one of my weak links. Like, you know, basically don't interact with him because you'll just drop the ball immediately.
Yeah, same here. So it's very scary. He's laugh a second. Everything that he comes out of his mouth is absolutely, utterly rubbish, but so funny.
But Suresh, we don't even listen to each other sometimes. We just find things funny together.
Yeah,
I don't know. It's almost like a romance. There's like a sexual chemistry, but not sexual.
And you know? I always had a soft corner for Parsis anyway. So
yeah.
So and you grew up watching Bakra, as you said, no?
He's older. Check the Aadhaar card. Aadhaar card dikhao, beta. Show. Nonsense.
Serves you right for, you know, being unshaved and trying to sport salt and pepper beard and all this stuff.
Entire blitzkrieg of press has only been about our age. Do you realize at the end of it, every time, and Ankita sweetly, without trying to be mean, puts us down every 5 minutes.
Yeah.
We've been called stalwarts.
Legends.
Legends are theek tha, I thought, but
monuments.
Legends is horrible, actually. You should be dead. Then a legend. Live legend is horrible. Not
true. But honestly, what was it like? 10 of you and Bamman and Arshad, what was your take on your host? There's a lot about you. Well, let's hear it from you all.
See, I would just say that I was hoping, actually, that there'd be people you don't like. Because instinctively, you don't like someone, you won't be interested in laughing at them or with them. Or, you know, because I think that's half the battle. Even with comedians, you like certain personality is more than just their copy, you know, so they for whatever reason, they appeal to you or you know, you get into it. So the same thing is with these guys, but I couldn't get that anger, which I wanted. I really wanted to find that anger amongst 2-3 of them that, you know, they irritate me, the young guy trying to be too cocky or, you know, next gen trying to put us down, put us in our place, or, you know, Baman, or I know them too well, Baman and Arshad, but, you know, just hoping that they hit the wrong.
Baman and Arshad, next gen, you're calling them.
No, I just remember to put them in because they feel very offended if you don't mention them every 20 minutes.
Yeah.
But otherwise, you know, who will know who they were and what they were doing at the show? We still don't know what they were doing on the show, frankly. Yeah. So the idea was to try and project some sort of negativity in people, but I wasn't able to get that. They're all basically very nice. In fact, now thinking about it, I think I should start instaing all of them. What do you think, Suresh? Would they think it's creepy?
I got Arshad's number.
I was talking about the ladies.
Oh, ladies. I don't think they'll even respond to my Insta messages, but perhaps your messages, they may.
Hey, Sala, Kusha Kapila ke saath kya hua? Your numbers went up by 50,000 or something because she said happy birthday to you.
She was very sweet enough to repost one of my posts that I did on Insta.
You know how you help an old man cross the road? You take the hand and say, uncle, aajao, koi tension nahi, and all that. You sort of, you know, slowly, whatever, stop the traffic, you know. Like that, she helped him.
Billions and millions of followers, you know.
She's got some 60 million followers and she gave him some 10.
And I think that's good enough for me, you know.
I think that's high bar.
Amazing. But guys, just tell me something. Do you find it annoying when people expect you to be funny all the time? Because I know the thing is, they look at you, they smile, and they'll come to you. And any fan moment, where it's like, joke, bata do.
I still remember this one incident, which is it's etched in my memory. I'll never forget it, perhaps. You know, it's an instinctive funny bone that you have. So this was quite a few years back. It's a bit of a sad story, but I'd lost my mom in 2002. And I had really broken down. I was, I was shattered. I've still not gotten over it. That's bad. And then I remember this guy from ETC where I was working. He came and stood behind me, and me and my brothers had really lost it. We were like, we didn't know what was going on, you know. And he came and tapped me from the back, and I turned around and looked at him, and he had this very funny, concerned face that he had made. You know, so, and see, I still feel like laughing. I actually wanted to laugh because his face was really funny at that time. And then he said, Suresh bhai, tumne nahi bataya. So my instinct was to almost, I retorted saying that mummy ne mujhe bhi nahi bataya. You know, and I wanted to laugh. So I put my hand in my mouth and I told my brother and said, bro, you know, I don't know, this guy cracked something really so insanely stupid. I'm finding it funny. I don't know, if I laugh, they'll perhaps take me to the hospital thinking I've lost it completely, you know. So then he gave me a warm, big hug and he said, okay, you stand still. So it's bizarre. So at these circumstances and something like this happens, no, it's like you're really blessed to have this funny bone to look at the funnier side of life. So I guess it's a blessing, you know.
But when it comes to death and Indians, urban Indians, we really say the most insensitive thing. The point is they don't mean malice, so you have to let it go as you did. But honestly, boss, the things, you know, I can't... Why would you ask someone what happened after 7-8 hours when you know 800 people have asked the person? Do you need to ask the person what happened? And then they make the appropriate face.
And the so thing sad.
Why?
नहीं बताया हुआ समथिंग नो आई मीन नहीं बताया हुआ समथिंग रियली वियर्ड सुरेश भाई नहीं बताया नो
नहीं बताया मींस नो ऑब्वियसली
इट वाज लाइक वाओ मैन
यू हैव टू रिपोर्ट टू हिम इमीडिएटली विद एवरीथिंग दैट हैपेंस
इट वाज रियली बिजार सो या दीस मोमेंट्स डू हैपन बट दे
दैट्स अ प्राइस टू पे
यार
या I'm sure there's never a serious moment.
No, I have lots of problems. You know, I'm a very short-tempered person also. So I physically, I'm still physically fighting at 40. I had a fight 3 weeks ago with a taxi driver.
Why would
you? Him in the head and then, you know, the crowd came and all that. My wife was telling me, what is wrong with you? You know, you're 49. You cannot have an 18-year-old. I should live in Gurgaon, firstly. Because, you know, I'm very impulsive. I need to go to a place where impulse is appreciated. Because out here, you know, suddenly I go from 0 to 100. So trust me, I have problems. But I won't bore you with that. But I'll tell you, Bakra cost me a lot in life. Firstly, because everybody keeps talking about that show. Don't let me do anything after that. And secondly, lots of people do things on me, which is not fun. Like, for example, next to my house, there's a bookshop, which no longer exists, or it's still there, actually, under Kemp's Corner, Crossword. And they used to charge, the parking was literally in the 90s, it was when it opened, it was something like 3 rupees an hour or 2 rupees an hour. So I took my son there for whatever, the birthday party or whatever, and finally found the parking, parked the car. And after the thing, I come back, just a couple of hours there, he says 50 rupees. I mean, literally from 2 to 50, literally, I mean, not even 2 to 5, 7, where you raise your eyebrow, this is 2 to 50. And I just fell for it. I was screaming at him, MCBC and all that. I won't give you, I won't use the exact words. Then after 2 minutes, and the pause was horrible. He paused quietly and looked at me, and all the respect and love for me, obviously, that he had went. And he said, सर जी आप तो बकरा बनाते हैं पूरे लोग सब सब लोग के सब बकरा बनाते हैं बकरा करते हैं और जब आपके ऊपर बकरा होता है तो क्या होता है and my 8-year-old son or something was standing there and 6-year-old son or whatever the hell the age he was then and he was also quite appalled that the lack of respect in the eyes it's terrible when that happens like in front of me like in live 35 mm to see the guy go from hero to zero as in me and I felt so bad Pooja in the car I felt wanted the world to swallow me up you know you read those lines in novels the world swallow me up I felt horrible I was like what's wrong with me why did I go to 100 why couldn't I just take a beat for a second and he was better than me he should have been MTV VJ because he did it beautifully he was very you know deadpan in a very matter of fact way like they are actually you know when you pay kitna ho gaya 50 rupees he just threw it he didn't make a big deal and all and when I reacted he did not react back he just let me just you know fire away yeah and then he looked me up and down for a good 10 seconds and destroyed me in that pause and then he said
and that guy went on to become one of the contestants in our show
yes
Akshay wow
Pooja, we're kidding, huh? Before you write that and they sue us
but honestly car, what do you think about attendant. Humor and...
Sorry,
what do you think about humor in these times? And sometimes you get offended with everything because, you know, you see our humor quotient is just like dipping. We can't laugh at ourselves.
Yeah, but you know, Suresh and I discussed this before also. Offense doesn't mean the person is right. The right to offense is there, but that doesn't mean the person who's offended is right. People confuse the issue. So we back off generally. Obviously, I don't want to upset anyone. Honestly, I don't see the point of that. So someone doesn't understand what you're doing, I always say sorry and back off. When we're talking about famous celebrities and all that, there are soft targets like sportsmen and film stars and there are stronger targets like politicians.
I know. That happens with me all the time. Film star?
Yeah, but he takes it in his stride. He's a beautiful man. Judged by the hair.
And sir, tell me, sorry, yeah, the hair, yes. But please tell me, please elaborate on this.
You know, we film stars, you know, we have to wear...
Oh, yes, of course.
Yeah, we have to
wear the brand. He's had 58 films. in six languages.
I've seen a few of them. I've seen a few of them. Oh, Hera Ferry, one of them.
Not Hera Ferry. There are many more than that, huh?
Yeah, thank you. Hera Ferry is, yeah, thank you. You know, but we do face a flack in anything that we do is judged by the crowd. You know, these millennials today. They judge, they call us boomers, they call us whatnot, they call us names.
I think so, boomers to ho gaya sir, we graduate.
By the way,
boomers ke upar aa gaya bhi.
Bro, I was noticing some Twitter feed today. I realized the sense of humor is very thinly defined nowadays, you know. So basically, I've heard the new age stand up comedians also diss the old form of humor, like they'll diss on a like a Sunil
skit format, yeah,
skit format, sketch format, or mimicry format. They'll diss on that. At the same time, they say that, you know, I don't know why humor is being banned. So I find it too.
Yeah, it's cannibalism, it actually. You're right.
Cross purpose.
Comedy cannibalism.
Strange.
It should,
so
it should be stopped.
It's all right
stop
to pull others
like
down.
Hum sab ek hai.
Yeah, exactly. That's what.
We'll start a union.
Yeah,
that's, that's one thing left to do now. We charge 1 rupee per comedian. There were some 1 crore comedians in the country.
Oh, yeah.
पूरा देश ही कॉमिक है कॉमिक्स का है बट शायद साहब यू नेवर डिड अ फिल्म या
फिल्म दैट सेवन
आई मीन लाइक नॉट यू हैव बट लाइक
या
लाइक
सॉरी लाइक वी आर वेटिंग फॉर वन टू रिलीज बट अनफॉर्चूनेटली इट्स ऑन अ सिस्टर ओटीटी सो आई कांट डिस्कस इट हियर
ओह या
आई मीन यू डन बट लाइक मिस्टर सुरेश मेनन ना लाइक शुड हैव मेड अ करियर इन मूवीज आल्सो नो
सुरेश टोल्ड मी देयर स्पेस फॉर ओनली वन अमिताभ बच्चन एंड दैट वाज हिम
आई मीन ही वाज वेरी क्लियर इट्स पूजा इट्स हैविंग सेड दैट इट्स It's very tough.
And the one film we did together didn't release.
Get, you know, especially came from TV. Yeah, one film we did.
That's the truth. That's true. This is not a lie.
Because we came from television to last in movies also. You know, it takes a lot of, I don't know. It's sort of, you know, then it's a different world out there. And I'm glad that Brocha never had to go out and look for film work because he was really entrenched very well in MTV. Like
yeah,
MTV
true,
and
true.
Brocha was synonymous with each other.
You so, said,
then really? MTV, it was Brocha.
Can I tell you, for the movie Masti, the first one, they had come to me. What is the writer's name?
Milap Zaveri. Rati
Boy, Milap. Yeah. They had come to Loveline. And the role that finally Hrithik Deshmukh played. Hrithesh Deshmukh played. And MTV didn't give me permission. Because they wanted 6 weeks or 4 weeks. There was one big block for a long
time. Yeah, I mean, then
Yeah.
You would have been here instead of Ritesh.
I would have been Ritesh. Yeah, I could have been a contender.
Yeah.
But what is that one thing you want to actually tell comics, stand-up comics also, that they should not do? And the one thing that you should do, seasoned comedians.
First, never advise anyone. I don't think I should do that.
Correct.
So I will not do that. I think people should just express themselves. And this offense meter has to be a little bit more flexible. I mean, obviously, if you just abuse somebody's parents and all, I mean, that's funny in a group of five people who hate one person. But otherwise, what's the point of that? So I think just there's that. But otherwise, you know, any form of satire and whatever, you know, we can't go on like this. It's no fun.
Yeah.
People should be allowed to make fun. Maybe we should have a zone where you can make fun, you know, like Hyde Park. You have a zone, one area. Maybe Panchil Park in Delhi would be good. I have cousins there. And you can gather there and you perform. And you abuse whoever you want. People should not take it personally. And then you exit and it's over. There's no, you know.
Yeah,
so
that's a great idea. Just get it out of your chest. What do you want to say?
It's like rugby or cricket. So on the field, you'll be as aggressive. You fight, you punch, hit, abuse, whatever. And when you leave, you all have a beer together.
Yeah, I got an idea. So, bro, let's open a restaurant over here, a bar cum restaurant called Vent. It's V-E-N-T. So everybody who comes in, there is no censor. There's nothing. You can come vent, whatever. Everybody's invited. Politicians, actors.
And a disclaimer cricketers. Saying that you may take offense. So if you're one of those who takes offense, don't come in.
Yeah, don't come in.
Huh.
Yeah.
But it will be veg and non-veg. Huh? I don't want one of these.
Yeah,
two. I know you're veg, so I don't want any trouble.
So veg and non-veg. Veg and non-veg. I'm happy with bread butter.
It's a 50-50 deal or 60-40 me?
No, 50-50.
No, yes, sir.
Guys, I was the one who's asked the question. Give me at least 10%.
Oh, damn it. Okay.
Let's do it. I exam 10%.
40 Pooja, 40 me, 20 Suresh, and it's a deal.
Done deal. But it's wonderful that you've come up with LOL. When have you had that LOL moment ki hase to ab hase?
Sorry, I didn't hear that. My wife was shouting.
Then did you have that LOL moment ki hase tho pase?
In the LOL or in life?
In the LOL or in life. Actually in life. Because LOL you're going to watch.
In life, I told them the other day we went to a funeral, my friend Kunal and me. And, you know, so when it comes to Hindu funerals, he's written the book. So he coaches me on how to go. We have to be very sincere and go with 10 minutes left for the funeral. So that you are known, seen, and you don't have to spend the whole time there. And then you meet the main people on your way out. So I followed all his rules. Everything was perfect. we entered there and I could not recognize our friends and all who should have been there. The, you know, people in the group should, couldn't recognize them. They said, "Sab log, you know, pehle se aa gaya, so maybe they've gone to another area and we are at the back benches, whatever." Then we realized when we went to meet the people who were standing near that slightly elevated area, it was the wrong funeral in the wrong place. And I started laughing because it was all his fault. He's so pompous, that Kunal. He's so pompous, yeah. No, I'll tell you. It's a Hindu funeral. You go 10 minutes before the end of the funeral, so you don't waste time. All right? And make sure you're seen with the main... All the medical lecture, bhashan dene ke baad, I did everything he said, the way he said, dressed the way he said, and he went there. And it was the wrong funeral. And I laughed. And they all turned. Because everybody's doing that acting of, you know, looking down and feeling very scared and worried about politically incorrect moment in a funeral and someone died and all that. But yeah. Oof, that was scary. Suresh has had a few moments. Oh, I'm changing chairs. Keep talking.
Okay.
I'm here.
Oh, no, it's okay.
See, it's me. Pooja, it's me.
Yeah, no, don't worry. Carry on, we won't talk about you.
Yes, I'm here. Nice guy. See, now I have a brown chair. Nice, I had a white chair, not racism. Now it's brown.
Okay, damn it, he didn't go away.
Shit, I've lost a couple of
inches. He's a nice guy, basically. That's what I wanted to say. That's it.
Who? Yeah.
You. Since you're here, I thought you'll turn your back, you'll go out of the frame.
You sarcastic bastard.
God. Anyways, yeah. So Suresh, all ben...
Suresh, tell your story.
Oh, my story.
Make up another one.
No. I'll never forget this. Jose Kovaco pulled this on me when we were on air. We were English that time, Red FM. It was my first stint as an RJ. Jose used to be the guys pushing the buttons on the other side. And I was just giving my voices and doing weird things. So in between, suddenly, it's a little bit non-veggie humor over here. So he just, out of the blue, he just asked me, "Hey, Suresh, do you know how we used to blow bubbles during our childhood and all?" So I said, yeah, of course. What a wonderful time I had. So he said, "There's good news for you." So I thought maybe they're doing some activity where you get to blow bubbles in the studio, you know, mess around. And he says, "Well, good news for you is that Bubbles is back in town." I cracked up after that so much. I couldn't stop laughing. For the next three links, you know, every time he came on and he said, "Okay, 90.5, Red FM, and Suresh Menon here with us." And Suresh, and I would say, "Hello," and I used to just go on laughing. Three links, I was only laughing. Because I couldn't control my laughter because I found it so funny.
Pooja, that also happens, I'm sure, with you also. No? There's one word or something that causes a joke, and then that word becomes insurmountable after that. Insane. You can't deal with that word in public. You say the same word or the same person ka reference, and that reference to context happens and everybody laughs.
Oh, yeah.
That's a horrible
thing.
It's
like even during shooting of Beja Fry 2, I remember Vinay Pathak and me at this moment on heavy duty, deadly dialogue, I'm telling KK Menon. And Vinay looks at me like this. He had a very weird way of looking at me. The moment he looked at me, I burst out laughing. So both of us started laughing. And then Amol Gupte, it was like we were shooting in the middle of the night somewhere in Indonesia. He got so angry. He said, "Why don't you discipline yourself?"
Thank you so much. Looking forward to that show. And actually, who was the guy you thought would go first? I mean, we see the show, but both of you.
I felt Baman and Arshad, both being starved of female affection, tended to look more towards the ladies than us. I always felt like we were like a community that was, disenchanted, disenfranchised and all that. And Suresh complained to me a few times also, ki the moment he's talking to a girl, Baman's eyes light up and there's much more, you know, it's almost like the body has more blood in it. You know, he's just suddenly interested. Talking to us, it's more distant and he's not even...
Anyways. We need lol in these times. Thank you, guys. Lovely chatting with you. Thank you, Pooja. We don't have another day.
Sorry. How is Delhi right now?
It's okay. A little bleak and, you know.
But is it as bad as they keep showing on the news or is it coping?
It's as bad.
Okay.
So fingers crossed. I hope.
Yeah, I'm a big Delhi fan.
Vaccination, yeah. Just hope good times are there for us. And thank you, guys, for making us laugh in these times. We need more people like you.
Hail the comics. That sounded like, what are we doing?
If you've liked this interview, please like, share and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram.